Peace tech lovers, TechTube here back with a new video. So if your Wi-Fi is really slow and you do not know where to start to fix it, then we are going to show you how you can fix your slow Wi-Fi in just a few steps. So without any further ado, let's get started. Hello guys, I know that many times you have questioned yourself, what can you do to make your Wi-Fi internet speed faster, as it seemed to be very slow and you are not able to get the best out of it. So today we will give you the best solutions to change your internet experience forever. So basically, there are major factors that can easily make or break your internet browsing, starting with your router position. As many people underestimate the importance of picking the right spot for a Wi-Fi router, and what they do not know that even with a small shift in positioning, the router could end up causing slow Wi-Fi. And the reason for that is, it can be very challenging for it to distribute the Wi-Fi signal. So you might have thought that you chose the most reasonable outlet and left it on whatever was nearby, a shelf, a desk, or even the ground. As it turns out, the router height does make a difference. Leaving your router on the ground or behind another object usually results in a significant worse performance. So the first thing you need to do is to put the router as high up as possible to extend the broadcasting range of the radio waves. This also helps clear the router from any potential interference, and materials like concrete and metal are usually the biggest blockers of the Wi-Fi signal. So you need to put that into consideration while positioning your router. Another key factor is the distance. The further away from your router you get, the weaker the Wi-Fi signal. Therefore, the best option is to place your router as close to your devices as possible. However, this is only practical if you have one main area where you tend to use your Wi-Fi enabled devices. Otherwise, you should place your router near the center of your home after all the Wi-Fi broadcasts in 360 degrees, so it doesn't necessarily make sense to put it at one end of the house. However, if your router's broadcast is very weak, or if your house is particularly large, then you might need to increase the range of Wi-Fi waves. In that case, Wi-Fi extenders or repeaters can be the best solution, because you can connect them to the main router and repeat the signal to cover a greater area. You most probably do not feel anything while the electromagnetic waves passing through you all day long. But that is not the case with your router, as it operates within a limited bandwidth, and anything that is within range operating with the same bandwidth can dramatically slow its performance due to signals overlap and high interference. For example, microwave ovens operate at a frequency of 2.4 GHz, which is incredibly close to the 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi band, as it actually broadcasts between 2.412 GHz and 2.472 GHz. So there are times when the microwave frequency can overlap with the Wi-Fi frequency. When that happens, the data being transferred gets disturbed. Most microwaves have proper shielding, so no waves should be detected outside of the oven. But interference can occur with inadequate or poor shielding. Similarly, one of the other popular wireless connections is Bluetooth. Also happens to operate at 2.4 GHz. In theory, a properly designed device should be shielded in a way that prevents interference. To avoid frequency clash, Bluetooth manufacturers use frequency hopping, where the signal randomly rotates between 70 different channels, changing up to 1600 times per second. And even newer Bluetooth devices can also have the ability to identify currently in use channels and avoid them. But interference can still occur, so try moving the router away from any Bluetooth devices, especially if they are older devices without the channel management feature. It's 2019, so nearly every household had its own Wi-Fi network, which can create channel overlap. This can cause issues in a townhouse, but especially problematic in housing complexes and apartments with many routers nearby. Channel overlap is mostly an issue for routers that can only broadcast at 2.4 GHz, or if you have devices that can only receive a 2.4 GHz wireless signal. This is because there are only 14 channels to transmit on. Two routers on the same channel at the same frequency will interfere with each other and slowing everything down. That's why it's crucial that you pick a proper channel in your router settings. Modern routers can't choose channels for you automatically, but sometimes it's better to set one yourself depending on your current network situation. Also, changing your default DNS can help a lot with your browsing speed. A software like DNS Jumper can be very handy to change your default DNS to a private one in just a couple of clicks. It will search for the fastest server and apply the settings for you, so you can give it a try, and I will leave you the link in the description box below. Finally, the number of devices connected to your router can make it run very slow, even if they are in idle state, because most of the devices get their updates for its software or the apps in the background over the Wi-Fi connection. So you might need to disconnect the Wi-Fi connections from all devices that are not currently in use. I hope you found such information helpful, and thank you so much for watching. As always, do not forget to like the video, leave me all your comments and questions below, and I will see you in the next video. Peace out.